I'm Avon.
And I'm Beverly.
Today we have Beverly joining us. Sonia will be back with us next week.
I can't wait.
And today we're dishing with you from Floriana Restaurant, located at 1602 17th Street Northwest.
I couldn't wait for Sonia to come back, but I'm actually happy that you're here as well.
So. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
And speaking of a guest of ours, we have Jason Wright, who is an extreme sports athlete as well as a professional artist.
Yes.
And he's here to talk about Take You Home. What is Take You Home?
It's a show I have opening at Gallery Plan B on 14th Street from July 28th to August 28th. The opening reception is July 29th, and it's basically it's a show of a body of work about the idea of shelter, like of homes and what they mean to the individual, and when people no longer live in a home, when it becomes just part of the landscape. So it's kind of a whole play on that.
And so what was your inspiration for that? How did you decide to focus on that as an artist versus anything
else? Actually, when I was in Arizona this winter, I saw a bunch of subdivisions that were built but abandoned.
Because whole subdivisions?
Whole subdivisions, like track homes that went for miles that were like 90% finished. Like there was no windows, no doors, but they became part of the landscape. And it was so eerie but beautiful and also sad that it just inspired me to do a whole body of work on it.
Now when you're an artist, what kind of art are we talking about? Is this
I'm a knife painter. Palette knife, no brushes.
Oh.
So just a knife and oils, mostly oils, a little bit of acrylic, but no brushes at all.
How does that work? Describe the technique.
It's sort of like spreading butter or icing a cake, but to do houses and stuff, sometimes you have to tape things off, or it's actually a lot harder than using a brush.
Or like spackling a wall.
Sort of, exactly. And I like it because it's challenging.
So it's pretty broad strokes, then you don't get like really detailed in there, or can you?
You can, it's just
really
the angle that you use the knife. Sort of like if you're using an X-Acto blade or something like that.
You're also a skydiver, and you say that you combine your two loves, skydiving and art. How does that work?
I usually get inspiration for the skies of my paintings from my training in skydiving. Like, we usually train in the mornings, and because of the light and the angle with the clouds and the different levels of the atmosphere, it's really, it almost imprints in my mind.
Uh-huh.
And I'm like, oh, I want to paint that with my little row of houses at the bottom.
Uh-huh.
So that's kind of how it works. And it also is adrenaline rush.
I'm having difficulty putting the two together because I'm picturing you jumping out of a plane. And
with a knife.
With a knife. Which is sort of worse than running with scissors.
And then paint you with the other hand.
And then, which is worse than running with scissors and then coming down and actually,
That would be a little dangerous.
That would be a lot
dangerous. Yeah, but I do train in the mornings, and it is a drug. It's an adrenaline. And I'm so hyper and happy when I'm done skydiving that I want to go create art, and I paint, and I kind of feed off that to like create my art.
Now, a lot of times on the show when we talk to artists, this is a city where people use both their left and their right brain, and during the day they have their 9-to-5, and then at night they're working on their artistic activities. But it sounds like you kind of are
I've always been the black sheep of DC. I've been here about 5 or 6 years, mostly in the summers, and it's kind of always felt like I was a black sheep here because of my lifestyle, because I leave in the winters and go to Hawaii, and I kind of follow my passions. I've always been a free spirit.
But how does DC receive this kind of extreme lifestyle that you have going on?
So far, good. At first, I would say it was bad. Like, people didn't know how to categorize me, where they thought like I didn't really work. I just did a coffee shop. And then once people really see what I do, like as far as my art and my skydiving, I felt like I've gained their respect. So,
does anything here in particular inspire you? You mentioned that skydiving, you're inspired by the sky. I would imagine sometimes it's kind of difficult to skydive very close to Washington. You can do it in the burbs, but not in DC.
Well, we actually do it next to Philly, about 11 miles outside of Philly. Since 9/11, you can't skydive in the metropolitan area around here, unfortunately. But I love DC. DC, is a good energy here. It really inspires me. I think it's changing. I think DC's really changing. I come back every summer and I can see the difference. Like when I walk down the street, the people are more, it seems like they're celebrating the arts a little bit more and supporting it, which I think is great.
So have your travels inspired you with your art? For example, you mentioned Arizona and the track of vacant tenements.
Exactly. And I've focused on that when I travel. Like when I'm in New Zealand or France, I look for the same kind of economic failure, where I can make beauty out of it.
So do you see that here in D.C.?
I've seen it. D.C. is kind of an enigma of its own because of all the government here. But I see it here. I mean, I see condo buildings that were supposed to be condo buildings, and now they're rental units, or, you know, they're 50% full.
How did you translate that into your art? Would it be more kind of graffiti?
My art is really, it's kind of nostalgic. Like, I want it to have kind of an eerie, haunting feel, but like beauty and darkness. I look at my art as kind of like when you're a child and you have your favorite toy, but when you grow up, you walk right past it. Like, you don't really notice it anymore, you don't appreciate it. That's how I look at, like, the body of work I'm doing with homes and the four walls we live in, and what does it mean when you no longer live in it, or it's never actually a home yet.
I didn't mean to cut you off, but I'd be curious that you mentioned the condo buildings, and I've noticed that a lot of times at night, you see, like, maybe one light on, or two lights on, and the rest of the building is dark. Do you ever notice that? And
I do. I do. I live in a condo building that's one of the highest in D.C., right down the street, actually. So I do get to look out and see that, but I don't paint condo buildings usually.
Not yet,
at least. Maybe one day.
Where can we find the exhibit?
Gallery Plan B on 14th Street, and the opening reception is July 29th.
Is this a traveling exhibit, or is this the first time that you've shown this exhibit?
It's the first time this body of work's shown in D.C.
Oh, so you're looking for feedback.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Are you selling the paintings as well? Or selling the knifings?
Well, the art is for sale. I show in D.C. about every 2 or 3 years because of my schedule. So it's been about 2 years since I've shown here, so I'm really excited.
And we've been talking about art for a minute now, but you also said you're a professional athlete as well.
Yes.
So is that part of the reason why you leave the area, the country, to professional
skydive? To train, to follow the weather.
Okay.
Because you can't skydive when it's too cold or windy. Plus, I spent a lot of my life in Hawaii, and I hate the cold. So whenever I have to wear a jacket, I'm out of here.
I'm the opposite.
You have to show off all of this. You can't cover that up in a jacket.
But I do leave, and the skydiving is awesome. I get to meet great people, and I get to train people like the Navy SEALs and other elite teams. And I'm very blessed that I've risen to a level that I'm at in 2 years.
Do you want to give people a price range for, is this affordable art, or is this the kind, if you have to ask, you can't afford it?
My work is affordable. It's like, I'm still like emerging mid-career, so it's definitely affordable. It's not outrageous. It's not New York City prices. You can't justify that in D.C.
Well, speaking of which, you were saying earlier that you skydived into Times Square.
Yes.
Can you tell us quickly about that experience?
We did it for an event. It was coexisting with my friend that is sponsored by Red Bull. Mm-hmm. And we skydived into Times Square for a show. And it was actually probably one of the scariest skydives I've ever done.
Well, I'll tell you what would be a scarier skydive is if you took that knife and you were doing your knife painting while I was jumping out of it. We don't want to see that, or maybe we do. Thank you so much for coming on.
Thank you very much.
We're really looking forward to checking out the exhibit. I'll have to say this is the first knife painting exhibit that I will ever have seen.
Okay.
And it probably will be yours too. Hope you check it out. Thanks as always for checking us out here on this episode of The District Dish.